So I just put 3.5 cups of raw hazelnuts on a baking sheet. I spread them out and I turned on the oven to 350 and just baked it until they got to a slightly golden color. Really, I just go based on my nose. Like, so stay near to the oven. It should be about 10 minutes. You don't have to let the oven preheat at all. Just pop it in there even as it's heating up, and that's included in my 10 minutes. You could keep it at a lower temperature. I wouldn't recommend putting it at a higher temperature. You just want to get a nice little roasted taste, which will, like I said, be about 10 minutes. Now, I'm doing 3.5 cups because we go through Nutella pretty quickly, but you can obviously do a lot less. So I would say, if you are just making it for yourself, don't want to freeze it, this recipe is definitely doubled. So just divide everything in half. Now, what I have here are some dates. And I always see all these different names for dates. I never pay attention. I always just buy whichever is cheapest organic. And so I switch. And I've just soaked them in almond milk. Last time I made this, I didn't have any almond milk, so I just soaked it in water. And they are pitted dates. And then what I like to do is sprinkle chia seeds, or flax seeds or hemp seeds, and some sesame seeds and nutritional yeast. So flax seeds have omega-3s. Sesame seeds have more calcium than milk, and then nutritional yeast has some B vitamins. So I let that also soak in the water, because, you know, a lot of if you already have all those things grinded, which actually one of the things I do is, let me see, no, I can't find it off the top here, but I do have a jar that I put, here we go. I put it down here so my daughter can reach it. So in this jar, I've just put flax seeds, sesame seeds, and chia seeds. So anytime I make a smoothie, today I made some lentils. These are leftover lentils made in Indian style, and I sprinkled it in there. It just makes it so much easier. So flax seeds can just pass through your colon, because they're so small, they never get digested unless you have them soaked, or if they're grounded, then they'll break down. But if you leave the flax seed whole and you just put it in on top of your yogurt without letting it kind of soak in your yogurt for a bit, it'll pass through. And I think even if you have it soak in your yogurt, it still may as well. I'm not exactly sure. So I put it in here, let it soak for a while, and then it'll get blended up. So I have dates soaking, coconut, and those other three items as well. Now, a lot of people will soak their nuts first. I haven't. I usually do that for other recipes because they say there's a poison on nuts. Hey, we're all going to die at some point. Just something I just don't do.